we go to the fifth theorem. If the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. So a quadrilateral is given to us here, quadrilateral ABCD. They have given that the diagonals bisect each other. The meaning of bisect each other is they cut each other into two equal parts. So quadrilateral ABCD is here. We have the diagonals here, the diagonal AC and the diagonal BD. They meet each other at the point E, and these two diagonals bisect each other. So when we write the given contents, we write in quadrilateral ABCD, diagonals bisect each other at, you see they meet each other at point E. So we write here at point E. Now if they meet each other at point E and the diagonals of the quadrilateral are bisecting each other, then the individual parts of each diagonal which are formed are congruent to each other. That is, in diagonal AC, segment AE is congruent to segment EC. We write it, segment AE is congruent to segment EC, and in diagonal BD, segment BE is congruent to segment ED. Segment BE is congruent to segment ET. Now what have we to prove? We have to prove that this quadrilateral, which they have given us saying that the diagonals bisect each other, that quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. So we write, to prove quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Now, in this figure you see here, we have two triangles now, triangle AEB and triangle CED. We take these two triangles because the sides here are involved, in which we are marking here that the sides are equal to each other. So, in triangle AEB and triangle CED, we have segment AE congruent to segment CE. We write here, segment AE congruent to segment CE. Now, how is segment AE congruent to segment CE? Both of them are marked with three lines. Same way here, in diagonal BD, what do we have? Segment BE is congruent to segment ED. We write here, segment BE is congruent to segment ED. Now both of these were given, so we write here given. Now, when we look at the figure, after marking these sides, we also see that the angles which are formed at this point E, which are facing each other, they are congruent to each other. Naming those angles, angle AEB and angle CED. So, angle AEB is congruent to angle CED. We write here, angle AEB congruent to angle CED. Now look at the figure. When we have to name which is the test by which these two triangles are congruent, we have the side here, the angle which is considered in between, and the other side. So SAS. So the two triangles, triangle AEB and triangle CED, are congruent by the SAS test. So we write, triangle AEB is congruent to triangle CED by the SAS test. Now here we said that these two angles are congruent to each other. They were facing each other. Therefore, they were opposite to each other, and therefore the angles were congruent to each other because they were vertically opposite angles. So now we have proved that triangle AEB is congruent to triangle CED. Now if triangle AEB is congruent to triangle CED, then angle ABD will be congruent to angle CDB. See here, angle ABD is congruent to angle CDB. So we write here, is congruent to angle CDB. Now how are they congruent to each other? They are congruent to each other by CACT. So how do we write CACT? Because once we say that the two triangles are congruent by some test, then the next pair of angles will be congruent to each other by the corresponding angles of congruent triangles. But we notice that these two triangles, angle ABD and angle CDB, they are alternate angles. Let us look at the figure again here. Angle ABD and angle CDB. This angle here and this angle here, they are alternate angles formed by this transversal BD of which segments? Segment AB and segment DC. So that is what is written here. But angle ABD and angle CDB are alternate angles formed by transversal BD of segment AB and segment DC. So if the alternate angles are equal, it is clear to us that these two segments, segment AB and segment DC, are parallel to each other. So we can write that segment AB is parallel to segment DC. How is it possible? By the alternate angle test. So we write here, by the alternate angle test. So if one pair of segments or one pair of opposite sides of the quadrilateral are parallel to each other by the alternate angle test, by taking another pair of triangles, we can prove that the other pair of segments or sides are parallel to each other. Which are the other pair of sides? That is segment AD and segment BC. So we can write now, similarly, we can prove segment AD is parallel to segment BC. So here we said segment AB parallel to segment DC, which was one pair of opposite sides. Then we said similarly we can prove segment AD parallel to segment BC, which is the other pair of parallel sides. So if both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel to each other, we know that the given quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So these are numbered as 1 and 2. So from 1 and 2, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram.